is already being spent, and there is nowhere to save money from.
It's that time again, folks, broadcasting live with his tin cans and a brand new string from atop Old Smokey. It's Ben, the King of Wiener Slingers, with a fancy co-host, with important guests, and the best answers a third-grade education can buy. All for you. Sponsored by Ben'sCarts.com, whiskey by the jug and donuts. You are so in for a treat today. But if I told you now, I'd have to kill you. So stay tuned. Ben's as nervous as a long-tailed cat in a room full of rocking chairs. Stand by. He's downing his last glass of liquid courage, and he'll be live in 30 seconds.
Have you ever wondered why the guy selling hot dogs always seems so happy?
Hello, Mrs. Smith. Hello, Mr. Johnson. Can I interest either of you in a hot dog? Do you want to find out why? LearnHotDogs.com. Get free video training, earn points, and get free stuff. Read Ben's hot dog blog and more. The premier source for hot dog vending information. Go to LearnHotDogs.com.
Well, folks, usually it's accompanied by a short story of their situation. I'm asked how to get started with no money, sometimes spend what we make. Other times it's just a matter of not enough income, period. Now, the point I'm getting to and we're going to talk about tonight is different ways to start a hot dog cart with little to no money. But before we get started, I would like to welcome everybody to the show. We have live at streetfoodvendor.tv if you want to catch it over there and look at all our pretty faces. We have Brian Shores with Elts Hot Dogs, and he's live on camera tonight. Y'all get to see his pretty face. And we've got Bubba Galt and
Doggy Daddy.
It's a mouthful.
There you go. And we've got the owner, CEO, head, in charge. I was going somewhere different with that, and that wouldn't have been right. And we've got the president and chairman of the board. We have Jason Brown of Love Hot Dog Company, and I would like to welcome all y'all to the show. If you would like to join us, send me a private message over at facebook.com/Ben's Carts and send a message in there, and I'll send you the link, and you can join us live here. But we'd love it if you'd show your pretty face. You can always call in to 424-258-9364. All right, Brian, you're first in line. Go ahead and tell us how your week went.
Lots and lots of rain. We finally got it dried out yesterday, today, and looks like it's going to be hot and dry for the rest of the week. So, but yeah, Friday was a monsoon.
So no beach goers, huh?
No. They don't like the rain.
Brian has the cream puff job, if y'all don't know. Kind of works on the beach, watches girls in bikinis. And he figured if he couldn't get a girl in a bikini to work his cart, he would just go watch them and work his cart. And so he works out of a concession trailer. It's Elts Hot Dogs. You can follow him on Facebook. Bubba G, let's hear how your week went.
We're still in the black. We ain't in the red, but we ain't much in the black. It was a slow week. I think Happy Jack's down in Greenwood, which is about 3 miles from where we're at, he said the same thing. It's like they extended their vacations. The Menards parking lot was very quiet all week. Saturday picked up. We had a great Saturday. But it was
well, good.
So we had a good week, and it's going along. We're still plugging.
I'm glad to hear it. And Jason Brown of Love Hot Dog Company.
Hey, we had a holiday for Bubba the other day. It was Bald as In.
That was Bubba's holiday the other day. I don't know if you saw that on
Yeah.
It was for you and Ben. Bald as In.
I missed it.
That was the holiday the other day.
That is my luck to miss the holiday.
Yeah.
Well, I'll be sure to catch the hairy back one.
Mine too. All the way down.
Well, we have we've had a good week. I got a show off. I got to meet I've known him for 4 years, but I finally got to meet him face to face. Mr. Michael Wood with Doug's Dogs, and I'm wearing the shirt he brought me. It is Kick Butt. It's got a hot dog on it. Wrong finger. This thing reverses me, and so I can't tell where the hell I'm pointing.
You can flip that around on the screen.
I've put the cigarette in my ear twice trying to watch the.
That almost sounds like a personal issue.
Did Brian fall off his chair?
I don't know. I heard some screaming and some pounding.
Off. Brian, are you there?
The woman in the basement is screaming.
Well, folks, I actually have a bunch of stuff planned for tonight, and I want to get started, and I want to run through these. At any point, jump right in there, interrupt me if you have a better idea or an idea to add on to these. I would love to hear it, but it is a common thing that I hear is, how do I get started with no money? Now, before I go into this, I want to give a little bit of information on about no money. Usually, if you ask somebody and they make $2,000 a month, they're broke every month. At the end of the month, they've barely got enough money to pay the bills to get through the month. The same reply will come from the guy making $4,000 a month and $8,000 a month. And I read a statistic fairly recently in a Forbes magazine article that talked about that most physicians were 2 months of income away from being bankrupt. Not that they're fixing to be bankrupt, but if they lost their income for 2 months, they'd be bankrupt. Well, this is because the American way is to spend what you make. If you make $5,000 a day, you'll probably spend $5,000 a day. We all think, hey, look, Brian's back.
Off the chair.
She's okay. Back up?
We thought you fell off the chair.
No, I had to check in on the woman, folk.
We tried to lean the camera down so we could see, but we were scared, you know, and I don't have that button to blur out the naughty bits, so I didn't just leave it straight.
I had to give her the warning that, you know, we were live on here, and I was part of the show tonight, so don't come walking through here with nothing on or anything.
Yeah, but when you got up, you should have put boxer shorts on, man.
You're assuming that I wear underwear.
Hey, I knew it.
Well, to give you a little more perspective on this, if you find that whether you're making $2,000 or $3,000 a month, if you're not paying yourself something each month, you are going to get further behind. And when I say pay yourself, is you pull money back that is not for movies, not for the electric bill, not for to help breed your neighbor's puppies. None of that. It's if you can make yourself put back 10% of your income and pay yourself first, after that builds up a little, even if it's $100 a month, eventually you'll get to the point where you don't want to spend that, and that becomes a buffer. Well, the problem with a lot of us is we get in this habit of spending what we make. My wife right now, if I gave her $500, I promise you by tomorrow evening, the Goodwills around our area would be $500 richer, because she loves them. And she will go in and buy all kinds of useless crap so that we can have a yard sale next summer and get rid of it. And she always thinks she's making money. But the bottom line is you have to create a way and be rigid with yourself enough to not spend that money. And so the first thing is when somebody asks me this, I always ask them, you know, what do you make? If you don't mind sharing with me, what do you make? And some of them tell me, you know, I make $4,200 a month, but my bills are like $4,180. Well, then you need to cut down on your bills. Because if you're spending what you're making, you're never going to get ahead. You're always working so that you can pay the bills, and it doesn't work good that way. The other thing is some people are just simply not making it. There's people that have been laid off, somewhere around 10%, 11% of our nation, and they don't have it. they're working menial jobs for minimum wage or a little more. And that is not enough to support a family. Even with two people working, it's simply not enough after taxes and your, you know, your Social Security and all that stuff. So it's a little tricky to I'm not judging those people. You're not able to save money because there is no money to save. So what we need to do is come up with some ways for you to make some money or save some money or be able to get a cart with little to no money. The trick is, and I've written down 9 of these, and I want to go through these with you, and fellas, if y'all have anything that you would like to add, jump in. You're not going to step on my toes. But the first one is work for another vendor. And this, you know, it seems like a no-brainer. You go, okay, I'll just go work for another vendor. Well, sometimes it's hard to find a vendor. You may have vendors in your area, and...
You work for me.
Yeah, like Jason. And there's some other opportunities, but there's vendors out there that may not be front and center. They may not be at the places you go by each day. And it may be worth you putting something on Craigslist. My next one, number 2, is going to go into a little more about that, keeping some fillers out. But you can rent from a vendor. How would you find a vendor that needs help, or find a vendor that is willing to rent you his cart on the days he's not using it, or rent you his cart, period? Well, one of the successful places to do this is a place called Craigslist. I'm sure you're familiar with it. You can put free ads on there, help wanted ads or wanted ads, and there's some little tricks to it. You could put an ad that says, I will buy your hot dog cart. You're not telling them that you'll pay cash for it. You're telling them, I want to buy a hot dog cart. Then you get some people that are searching Craigslist ads for hot dog carts, going to see what the market will bear before they list theirs, and they may call you, see the ad. There's vendors that have done this and are doing this. There's people like Jonah in Texas who was on a couple weeks ago. She wants to sell her cart and her business. It's a ready-made, making-money business, and she'll finance it with a considerable down payment. Well, that's not a little-to-no-money deal, but there's opportunities out there that are similar, and you need to find those. You can also list over at learnhotdogs.com. In the classified section, just go in there and create yourself an ad. The more people that do it, the more people will start to look for those areas when they're needing help, like Jason. Jason's constantly needing people. Corey has needed people in the past. A lot of us have needed people in the past, and it was hard to find them. Umbrellas. It would do what?
Brian needs people to rent umbrellas.
I was actually going to say, Ben, that gentleman that you pointed my way, I got in contact with him. And hopefully he's going to come down next weekend and work or check out the cart and everything like that. So, yeah, there's...
All right, so if he's working for you next weekend, you coming up here to work for me? Because I got, like, Friday night, Saturday, and Sunday.
Yeah, but if I go up there, then who's going to send you pictures of the, you know, office view every day?
Beach. Oh, you bastard. He sends me shout-outs on Facebook of the beach view. Like, I hope your fans break and there's not a cloud in the sky and it's hot as hell. And nothing but a busload of fat women in G-string show up.
Well, that's part of it, though, is that networking, and it's what we're doing here now. And there's about 8,000 people over there on our Facebook page, and you can network with people. I'm going to create some better ways to network so that you're not having to mill through people that are just looky-lookers or looky-loos, as my wife calls them. But we need to have a better way. But right now, we don't. And so I'm giving these tips out to help those of you that are wanting to get started but no money. I got 2 emails this week from people. One of them shared their story, a long story about how things were tough, and they simply didn't have the money to be able to do it. And it hurts my heart. If I was wealthy, I would just be a philanthropist. Is that a bug person, or did I say that right? I think I said it right. Anyway, I would love to be able to help people get started, people that are serious, but there's going to be some, there's going to be more work and more legwork. You're going to have more due diligence starting with no money than you would if you had some money. Now, let's talk about raising some money. This is number three, and it's fundraise. And you can fundraise locally, but you can also fundraise with crowdsourcing, with social networking crowdsourcing. There's several websites to do that. We've had some vendors on the show that have done it successfully. Indiegogo, there's Kiva Zip,
there's GoFundMe,
Kickstarter, GoFundMe. There's a ton of these that can kickstart, basically, pun intended, to get you. There's people out there wanting to help people that are self-motivated, willing to take the risk. But I want to tell you something about this. You know, because Kickstarter and GoFundMe and Indiegogo and all these have become so popular, and people think that they're going to, you know, that it's just small, they put their little ad on there. The problem is now there's millions of people listed there, and it's hard to sort through the ones that are serious and the ones that are just raising money so they can get their next boob job. Well, I, my daughter did that, by the way. the, anyway.
Bobby, you okay?
I'll probably get killed for saying that. But anyway, it's one of those things that you need to take as much effort and as much enthusiasm with your fundraising page at Kickstarter or GoFundMe as you do with everything else. If you would make a video, people like to see and hear you talk. They want to know you, and the only way to know you is to build a relationship, a rapport, and that can be done through video. You can also use comedy. There's been some unbelievable amounts raised through comedy. We featured a gentleman that raised, I think it was four times more than he needed, because he was comical in his fundraising. You know, he made some hot dogs in his kitchen, and he filmed it, and he smashed them, and he, you know, he talked about it, but he had serious points in it, but it entertained. Well, because it had an entertainment value, when somebody like me or Jason or Brian or Bubba or any of us, we see that, and we share it on our networks. And so those little things, and they may not go viral worldwide, but they go viral to the people that matter. And so if you can spend some extra time, and even if it's recorded with your little phone, you're going to come out better if you will put as much detail into the video and make it entertaining. And then you'll probably see the fundraising go up, because now it's not like every now and then you hear about a GoFundMe. I have somebody send me a GoFundMe or an Indiegogo thing they want, you know, to share every day, more than one. So there's lots of people doing it, but very few do it with a video or with some catchy stuff. And so I wanted to talk about how important that is. We've had to change how we do it because it's not working the other way. It's not working as well. The fourth thing I want to tell you about is Kiva Zip. And Kiva is another fundraising, but you're going to pay it back. So the odds are you're going to fundraise quicker, and you get to pay it back with no interest. So it's a interest-free loan to you to start your business, and you may want to check that out. Just type in K-I-V-A Zip in Google and check it out. You can also just type that in the search engine over at learnhotdogs.com, and it will pull up some several successful vendors that have done that, and it worked for them. So I want you to keep those in mind as you go. And I've got some more for you here, but I'm going to take a quick break, and we'll find out. Man, I get chill bumps. I feel like I got a real crowd.
Oh my me, Ben's got it A to Z. It's the A to Z course for anyone just getting started. It's brand new and full of fresh info, tips, and tricks on how to get rolling. In 11 on-demand web episodes, Ben does a comprehensive course on kickstarting your business. It includes forms, outlines, and more. He covers licensing, permits, finding a car, commissaries, locations, even more locations, tips, pricing, and shaving your dog, and more. You get it all except for the shaving your dog part. We just want to make sure y'all were listening. Get it now over to learnhotdogs.com. Hey folks, this is Rob Harper with Hot Dog Vendor Radio. Just a quick reminder that Hot Dog Vendor Radio is a live radio show. Without call-ins, there ain't no show. So hide your face, pick up your phone, and give us a call. You can use your real name, you can use your stage name. We aim to please, so we don't really care. The only stupid questions are the ones that are not asked. So dial 424-258-9364. That's 424-258-9364. Get your groove on with HDVR, Hot Dog Vendor Radio. Don't mistake it, girl, that's all you
ask of me. Darling, it is no joke. He's happier than a fat girl eating cake. It's Ben on HDVR, Hot Dog Vendor Radio.
Well, I'm walking to the room. Hey, folks, I appreciate that break. And do y'all have anything you want to add to this? Jason, Bubba, any of you, Brian?
I don't have a lot to add to it because I'm not one of those. I've never had to. I used to be one of those, but I don't. We have no debt. So trying to find the money usually just means going to work for a week or so and then we've got money again. So that's our situation, and I'm blessed. I busted my butt to get there, but I'm blessed because of that.
Well, and you served, right? You
No. We met the old school way. We met online.
No, I'm saying were you in the service, Bubba?
No.
No? Okay. No. I thought you were for some reason.
Would have made me right.
He looks like he could be an old jarhead.
But I've found a lot of vendors lately have come into this business who are retired, who, you know, have found that, you know, one, you want something extra to do, but also you like the additional income. There's people like, you know, I'm wearing a shirt, Doug's Dogs, Michael Wood out in Georgia, and he's making a full-time income vending hot dogs, you know, 3-4 days a month. And he's done well through that because of that. And I've seen a lot of people doing the same thing. I would like to move on. We're going to go to number five, and it's you could group with a nonprofit and offer to buy the cart back to help you get started. Let me explain that a little bit, because this is kind of thinking outside the box, and this, some of you may not be comfortable with this, but there are local charities who want to raise more money. They're local to your area. It can still be the Red Cross, or it can still be the Humane Society, but it's the one local to you. And if you would take the initiative to contact them and say, listen, I have a plan. I found out what I need to do this and this and this to get a cart. But my stumbling block is getting the cart. There's charities out there that would possibly co-op a cart with you so that you basically, they buy the cart, you raise money for them along with yourself. And as it goes, you would eventually be able to buy the cart off of them or save enough money to buy your own cart. These are things that can happen. They take a little more effort. But if you're serious about getting started, serious enough to send me an email that says, Ben, I really need help, then these are things you can do. There are charities out there that would love to find somebody that ran a food division for them so that they could go fundraise at their fundraisers, so they could have a hot dog cart in front of the door to their little auction they're doing every Saturday night or whatever they're doing. Or the next time they do the free spay and neuter at the Humane Society and they're trying to get donations, to have a hot dog cart parked up there would mean a lot. So there's all these little things that you could do to think outside of the box so that you could become a hot dog vendor, gain practice, and not have the expense initially because you simply don't have the money to do it anyway. And I think it would be an awesome way to get started.
Plus, it's a great way to get in. I mean, you get in with some of these organizations, and it can be a great networking tool. I mean, you get working with an organization and stuff like that, and you know, word can just get carried, you know, mouth to mouth and everything like that. And
we had that with Alex's Lemonade when I was still doing pizza. I mean, you know, you can't beat some of their networking with social media.
Right. We're trying to get hooked in. My wife still works at St. Francis Hospital, and they're trying to build a hospice for obviously older folks who don't have the money to do it. So my wife is supposed to talk to them. We'll get together and try to help them out because now is a good thing because I think my mom's going to move in with us. So we're going to be the hospice. But, you know, not everybody has that option, and we all have parents who get there. So it's a good deal. But it's that awesome.
Awesome that you have the ability, though, to do it. That's that's a blessing in itself to be able to have the opportunity to be able to take someone in like that that's taken care of you, that raised you, and that you can give back.
Right. Well, we give 10% of all our profits anyways to the Tony Stewart Foundation, which is for chronically
ill tires or what?
What was that?
Did that buy his tires or?
No, it's his foundation. he's got a really good foundation for chronically ill children and wayward pets, I guess you would want to call it, and what really race car drivers, your local race car driver that may not have a lot of insurance and he hits the wall and does himself up pretty good. So it's three main things that that foundation does, and so that's what we do. That's what we do. I like it, and I believe in it, and so we're doing it. It's kind of Indiana because he's Indiana, so... Yeah, we do it that way. And his mom's a hoot. So.
That's cool. Well, my number six one, and you've heard this one before if you've ever heard my story, is beg, borrow, steal, whatever you got to do from family and friends. And I sold everything that wasn't nailed down. Now, what I learned, you know, through my ordeal going from, you know, over $250,000 a year income to literally nothing overnight was that I could live on a lot less than I thought I could. And I quickly realized that I could save some money by getting rid of the $120 a month satellite bill, that I could get rid of all these little extra things that we had been doing. This, you know, my kids bleeding me daily of $15, $20 because they need this or that, you know, and, oh, we got to go to McDonald's after the track and blah, 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 blah. And if you start writing that down, and that's why keeping records is scary, but if you'll keep records, you'll find that you'll look back and you'll go, we spent $160 on Netflix or whatever. You know, I just made that up. I know Netflix doesn't cost, but we end up spending all these little bits of money places. Well, you should reward yourself, okay, for working. People feel obligated to reward themselves, but oftentimes we get into the habit of doing it when we haven't changed anything. And so that's what creates this living month to month, week to week, day to day. And so it's, you can take it from me. I was down and out, two bedroom, you know, mobile home with all the kids, and it was horrid. And I had to get rid of things. All of a sudden, everything mattered, everything. And I sold everything that didn't matter, everything. I'm talking furniture and stuff because none of it mattered. And I was able to get that hot dog cart. Well, a lot of us don't want to part with, you know, that 54 Chevy that's in the back, or, you know, I had a 1954 International pickup truck. I held on to it and held on to it and held on to it, and I thought it was worth thousands. I ended up selling that for like $300.
Damn.
It was actually one that said International Harvester. It was back in the 80s. And it ran. And so I sold it because I needed the money, and it was going to be it was going to solve a problem. It was going to give me more money to be able to buy the cart. And I didn't have time to wait. I didn't have time to get it on eBay. I didn't have internet anymore. So a lot of things changed for me. So you will. I was having to go to over to a neighbor's who was actually, you know, my brother-in-law, and use his computer to get on Craigslist to look for stuff and to sell stuff and list stuff. And so you find out quickly what you don't have to really live, and it's humbling, but it also shows you, you know, I could live off $2,800 a month. I don't really need to live off $4,000. So that extra $1,200 I'm going to put back every month. And you change these little things, and all of a sudden you get to the end of the year and you've got $8,000 in the bank, and you go, wow, I did it. Who's got $8,000 in the bank? There's very few Americans that can say that. Very few that have $8,000 in the bank.
Yep.
So it's one of those things that you have to, a lot of, you know, self-determination, self-motivation stuff. But that's what it comes down to, the begging bar, and that's why I felt like it needed to be included in my list. Number 7 is get a partner. This can be risky, but sometimes several people, and raise the funds. If you have friends or family that are like-minded and would be willing to create a 6-person partnership to get a cart, even if you're going to work it, you may get the bad end of the stick. But if it's a, what is it called, a method to the madness, it's there's a reason that you're, I guess you're sacrificing a partnership so that you can get what you want. And a lot of times in life we do that. We, you know, we don't fight with the wife so that we get dinner tomorrow night. And things like that. It's one of those things, so that we can go in the house and she's happy. You know, there's a lot to be said for living in a happy home. So there are ways to crowdsource. I've seen multiple vendors go together and get I know three that just went together and they got this was back March, April, in Orlando, Florida, and they got a food trailer, a concession trailer. And they all chipped in and they all saved and they got it. And there's already been a fallout, but the bottom line is they got it done.
Yep.
And there's ways to get these things done if you have the desire. Another thing is some vendors, this happened just recently, got permission to set up their powered steam table. They bought a commercial steam table, a tabletop one, and got permission from the health department because their commissary was right behind them in a restaurant. They got permission to set the steam table out front. Well, what it was actually is a bakery behind them. And so it wasn't a competitive edge. So the bakery allowed them to use their business as the commissary. They sat out front on the sidewalk in with a table. I'm talking a $20 table and an extension cord and a steamer. And they steamed hot dogs. And they've been doing this now for about 4 or 5 weeks. And I've asked this lady, she doesn't speak really, really good English, but I've asked her to come on the show, and hopefully she will. Her daughter speaks really good English, but I don't know if she'll do it. But the bottom line is they started with nothing. They basically started with nothing. She found this at a used restaurant supply place, and she bought it cheap, and it needed cleaned up, and one side of the thing doesn't even work. You know, it's a full-size steam table, and it's got 2 burners that come out that are electric, and one side doesn't work. And so she's doing everything on a half of a steam table, and she's making money. Well, why? Because she had to. That was her choice. And I admire that, because this lady one day will have her a cart, and this lady, she may not buy it from me. But that's called, I want to do this, and I'm going to figure out a way. And that isn't the only story. There's other stories of vendors stepping out and doing things, checking with the health department, and they go, hey, yeah, all you need is a table. As long as you got your sinks in there, we're okay with it kind of deal. There's those that happen. There's a gentleman in Washington, I don't know if you remembered him, he called in about a year ago. He did the exact same thing at a flea market. They let him use their commercial kitchen to be called as commissary, and he set up basically the same thing, and he didn't even have a steamer. He set it up with a turkey cooker, and it is doable. You can do this, and it's not the best way to go about it. It's hard to look professional with a turkey cooker and some cardboard signs saying hot dogs, but it it's another one of those deals, and I know Method to the Madness isn't the correct, and it may be, but it's not the one I'm looking for.
Means to an end.
Means to an end, yes. That's it exactly, Jason.
Gumption, chutzpah.
Exactly. And so those types of things, those are the people that will succeed even though they were given nothing, and I mean nothing. The other thing is you can build a cart. There's many vendors that have built a cart. Obviously, I'd love it if you go to, you know, buildacart.com and get your course, but if you don't have the money, there's you can build a cart. If you have some of that knowledge, it's really not that hard. Get a steam table. Buy a steam table to use restaurant supply store or something like that, and you can end up with a business for less. And you can always improve later. I get these calls from time to time, and they go, Ben, what's your best cart? Well, there isn't a best cart. It's a best cart to suit your needs, but there isn't like, I don't have like a tier system. Well, they go, what's your most expensive? Well, why? Why do you need that cart? You know, if I can start out with 500 or 3,000, I choose the 500. That's what I'm going to choose every time, because it's going to give me the fastest ROI, which is return on investment. And as soon as it's returning on its investment, I can then take profits and buy my next cart. I can buy a Cadillac cart later. I can buy a $60,000 concession trailer later. But it don't have to be today. I'm going to get there without spending that money or putting that much more pressure on my back. And so we all have pressure. We've all started this because we needed an income for our families. So there's no sense in making it worse on ourselves or setting ourselves up to fail. So don't spend. If you can find a used cart, buy a used cart. Some of you, I know, Jason in particular, may not agree with me, but I know that buying a used cart can sometimes be the difference between starting and not starting or succeeding and failing. So I'd rather you buy a used cart first if you're on that verge.
But look on learnhotdogs.com, find the article about what to look for when buying a used cart. Make sure you follow those steps. You know, don't be like some of these guys that don't do it and then they wind up coming back on the show or calling and saying, oh man, you know, the propane tank fell out going down the road. Well, you know, told you not to buy that because it was Luan plywood. You know, don't be that guy.
Right.
One of the other tricks when you were talking about the financial stuff, Ben, was the way that I finally stopped being the way I was. For 2 months, I took a little pad of paper, a little line notebook pad, and I wrote down every penny I spent. And at the end of every month, when I would look at that, I was like, holy God, I should have just thrown it up in the air and just given it away. It was just, you know, you don't realize your Cokes, you know, just stopping at a gas station or something like that. And I was on the road driving a truck, and that's, yeah, I realized, oh my God, I'm spending how much money on food,
right,
instead of stopping at Walmart and buying a cooler that was 12-volt plug-in and go to the grocery store and do that. And that's how I got on my road to get out of it. And my inspiration was because I knew I was going to marry her, and I didn't want her to marry my debt. That was it.
That was smart. And see, that took courage, because it is a lot easier driving down the road. I can hardly pass by a Krispy Kreme or a Taco Bell without pulling in. My car pulls.
Look at me, brother.
And so I was out of town today, and we were driving, and there's a Dunkin' Donuts next door to a Zaxby's, next door to a Taco Bell. And I told my wife I could literally move right behind there in a cardboard box. And now I'm on this special salad diet. I don't know if you can see it yet, but I've
You're making your hair grow.
I definitely pick out rabbits quicker on the side of the road than I ever have. So it's one of those things that it's easy to fall into the trap where you think, well, where would I save money? Well, if you write down what you're spending daily, if you'll keep a daily log, and you don't have to do this forever, write down for 5 days what you spend. Every dime, every time you whip out the debit card or pull out cash out of your pocket, write it down. And at the end of the day, tally it up. And at the end of 5 days, you will go, holy crap, here's where it went. It went to crap. Most of it crap you'll never get back. And there's no value to it at all. I mean, there's a value to Krispy Kreme. If it's Krispy Kreme or something like that, that's different. But the other stuff, not so much. I do want to welcome. Let me finish this real quick. That's basically it. There was nine ways to get started with little to no money. It's doable. It's been done. I hope that helps you that are listening. I would like to welcome Stephen to the show. Stephen, we can't see you, but we can hear you. You do have a pretty picture up, so we do have your face.
Can you hear me?
I can hear you just fine. How are you?
I'm doing good.
Well, thanks for joining us. Did you have a question for us, or did you just want to join in and hang out with us? Either way is fine.
I wanted to hang out, just part of the show tonight. I was trying to tie a microphone, my headset.
Well, you're coming through loud and clear, and I thank you for joining us here. We're glad to have you. I've got an email, and this is eerily similar to a lot of them I get, and y'all are going to pick out on this, but I want you to listen along, and I wish you had a ding, ding, ding bell or something when you hear something that I've covered numerous times in videos and stuff, but sometimes this stuff, it's hard for people a lot of times to go back through it all. They don't want to search 8 hours of video to find the three answers to the questions they have. The crappy part about this is I haven't turned this into an encyclopedia yet, and so we give out this information, and I may get calls tonight that answer a question I never, that I didn't think of, and so it doesn't really, it's not the gist of the show. Well, how would you find that? You wouldn't without listening to it or going to the show notes and stuff like that.
Bubba and Brian, they'll search.
There you go.
There's that bus again.
This one says, I'm starting a cart business in Wichita area. As of right now, I'm pretty much figured out my menu costs and marketing strategy. I've not yet purchased a cart or a cheap van I'll need to tow it around, nor have I set up a commissary. That leads me to my first question. In Kansas, apparently, you can actually have a home commissary as long as it is not attached to the house or kitchen. The health department suggested setting up in my garage. Do you have any suggestions for equipment? Specifically, I will need a cutting work table, at least a double sink, and a source for hot water. I know that I can go through a restaurant supply company and spend big bucks, but I don't want to. I found an L5 at Amazon and was considering repurposing that for my hot water. This is where the inspector and I spoke, and he was a little fuzzy and indecisive. I just don't want to waste money. Have you worked with anyone out here that has a home set up? And if so, what route did they go? This goes on and on, so I'm going to stop there and answer those questions. And if y'all have any ideas for this person, then feel free to chime in.
Craigslist for the equipment.
Craigslist for the used equipment?
Yeah, for the sinks, that kind of stuff. I mean, I've got some killer deals when we set up our commissary. I mean, I'm in a bigger setup that we're running out now to other vendors. But, you'd be amazed what you can find if you take your time and look.
Well, heck, if for his hot water, you could use hook the hose up to the water heater that Ben sells. There's your hot water.
Well, yeah. The L5, we've got the L6, and you can have – the L5 will work just fine. The L6 will work just fine, and it's cheaper, and it does more water at a time. Brian's got horns.
Brian's horny.
So the other thing is okay, you've got your equipment. I don't have anybody in that area that I can think of off the top of my head that can do this, but Craigslist is the way. You ask about, do you have any suggestions or stuff? I would find out exactly what the health department requires. Make sure that before you install it, if they would do a courtesy visit and show you what they want or what they're looking for, or if they have a drawing or a diagram that would help you, you're going to come out ahead without putting something in and then go, yeah, your hand sink is too close to your stainless steel prep table. I want you to move that across the room. And those things can get expensive, even though it may be $100, $200 to move it. Who wants to spend the $200 when you have a Krispy Kreme in town? Can you tell I'm starving for starches?
Fried dough.
Yes. America. Merkin. I saw a picture of the Eagle the other day, and they had a mullet on his head, and it said Merkin. Eagle. Okay, the next one. Same person. Apparently, let's see, second. What talking points have you found to be the best to convince a business to allow you on their property?
Got to bring them some kind of value or something, keeping employees there, bringing in traffic. It's got to be something.
You are a marketing source. You should attract people just by being there. If you're neat, clean, and set up nicely, there should be people stopping because you're there, or at the very least, you're making the shopping experience better. They can leave the store, grab a hot lunch at a good price, and leave. Wouldn't you say?
Yeah. I mean, you know, either you're bringing people in, you're keeping employees on site and on time, back to work, you know, something. It's got to be some type of added value.
Well, I think, I mean, even Bubba, haven't you ran into that now with being at Menards? Like I say, you get, you know, the employees don't have to leave and stuff like that.
Lunch. The employees love it because they don't have to leave, and we give them a deal because they've all liked the Facebook page, and they know if they just come up and say the phrase, they're getting a buck off the meal. So they're getting chip, soda, and dog for $4. But we switch up the menu enough during the day, during each other day, so we've got the employees coming on regularly. In fact, this Saturday we gave away 5 loyalty meals, you know, and it was all employees. So
that was smart.
We're giving some stuff away and we're losing some margin, but we're creating a loyalty to it, and that means more than anything in the long run.
Exactly.
Now, Bubba, do you use a frequent buyer card or anything like that?
Yeah, that's what we have. We have a loyalty punch card.
Yep.
And we punch it every time, and then when they get to the number 5, here comes the freebie the next time around. And I loved collecting those cards on Saturday. It was great, you know, because you've got to think long term. You don't think, okay, here's today. I'm usually thinking, it drives my nuts. My wife's crazy. I'm usually thinking 6 months to a year in advance, if not farther. Where's this going to be, and what's it going to take to get there? And I understand, because I've had 3 businesses. In the beginning, you do lose some money in the short run giving stuff away to get them loyal. Once they're loyal, you never give it away. You know, it means everything. And their word of mouth means everything, much more so than Facebook, Twitter, or any of that stuff. So if we've got them telling friends, because we've also do that with the business cards, we give them 3 of the business cards. They write their names on the back. And when we collect all 3 of those from somebody else that they gave them to, they get another free meal.
Right. There's
3 people that came in, and if they become repeat customers, they get the card, and then whammo, you know, it just grows it. So it's worth it to me.
Definitely.
Hey, Jason, there was a question. Let me block in here. There was a question from HD Ninja. He sent you a message on Facebook last week, and he wasn't sure if you'd had a chance to see it. So if you look at that, he's on the chat room. But if you had a chance, look at that.
Do me a favor. Type back, ask him to resend it.
Okay.
This is Doug's Dogs. I'm wearing his shirt today, thanks to him. And I met he and his beautiful wife in Sevierville last week. And this is his little card that he punches out. You buy 10 combos, you get 1 free. I don't know what happened to my video, but it disappeared on my end. But the gist is, I hope everybody got to see that. That's his little punch card. And you could get that at Vistaprint cheap, you know, 250 of them.
The other way to do it at Vistaprint's just, you know, in the beginning, if you don't have the money for business cards and frequent flyer cards, basically, like you say, yeah,
ours will be
same. Here's our card, right? That's our business card. But see that line across there?
Yep.
Everything below it, you just move it up and leave that bottom blank, and then go buy yourself a punch.
That's what we did.
Yep. And that way, you know, you're not buying 2 sets of cards in the beginning. Later, you can get yourself a nice card strictly for the loyalty program.
Yeah, our business card is right here.
Okay. I think this is the first time I've ever shown this, ever. That's
Yay.
My original hot dog card. It, you know, I found that picture online, and I thought I was original, and I've seen it about 1.5 million times since with the dog inside the bun, but I put it on my card. It was Hillbilly Hot Dog and Sausages Doing Dogs Right, and Ask About Catering, and you'll see my buy or eat 10, get one free punch card incorporated into my card, like Jason's saying. And then on the back, I always take advantage of the back. It cost it very little more, and I put, thank you for your business, Ben and Sabrina Wilson. And that goes a long ways yeah. with your customer. And so, especially giving them free stuff, too.
Yeah. Yeah, see, that's what ours is. And that there you see the star punch.
Yep.
In there. And that says, that has the Facebook thing, the email, the text us your order ahead. It's got everything on there. We only do 5 meal giveaway. We're foolish.
Yeah,
we do 5, get a free one. But like I said, in my mind, it works. And if I was the guy, I always put myself, if I was the guy standing on the other side of that table, hey, with the money, wanting the dog, what would I think was just really cool and what would make me come back? That's how I think through it, because I am one of those guys. I buy stuff.
It's loyalty. If people know that they can get something for like, let's say you're going out to eat and you know you've been to the hot dog vendor 5 times. Mine was basically the same thing, Bubba, because mine was 5 hot dogs. Our 10 hot dogs, so 5 meals got them the free one. So I'm going to have a loyalty to that vendor. You know, if it means driving another 2 blocks and passing Taco Bell and stuff to get me a fresh hot meal, and I know that, you know, my wife's going to eat free or one of the kids are going to eat free, I'm going to do it. It builds a rapport. And I know that's a little different for events and stuff, but a lot of vendors are doing this and building a social following like we talked about last week.
Yep. Well, that's like because of our position where we're sitting in the little city of Indianapolis. We really, I think you saw that post of mine where within a 5-block radius, anywhere you go, we've got 10 national fast food chains and 20 restaurants all within 5 blocks of where we sit. So we're in competition with a lot of folk. So you got to do what you got to do to get it. And it makes it funner because when we do have a good day, it's like I beat the big guys today. Ha! You know? So it's a challenge.
Well, on hold, and I'm going to go ahead and take them before I finish this email, and then we'll come back to it if we have time. Let's see. Give me just 2 seconds. Join us.
And you're quiet. Nope, can't hear you.
You can't hear me.
Oh, now I can.
Okay. I don't have a clue. I may have been too far from the mic. You can hear me?
Yep, now I can hear you.
Okay, so anyway, I'm going to go ahead and take some calls from some vendors. Let's see here. I apologize you having to wait. Area code 706, you are live on Hot Dog Vendor Radio and Street Food Vendor TV.
Hey, Ben, I like that shirt.
Yeah, sexy, isn't it? I got a good friend down in Georgia made that for me.
We do it good. I finally got the cart back working again Friday night. The only problem I had with it was I had 7 people in line at a time for about 2.5 hours. And I couldn't cook the food fast enough.
Oh, wow.
Then Saturday I had a little bit more time so I could regulate the heat, but Friday night I had to just run it wide open as fast as I could. I think we did like 600 in 2.5 hours.
Oh, my gosh.
You know, it was like, please, they were having fireworks, and it was like, please have fireworks quick. I'm tired. But I actually did something that Jason does a lot. I actually ran out of buns, and which is really different for me because I'd bought enough for to do two events. And the state sale Saturday morning, and I was going to use those buns, so I had to go get some more that Saturday morning before I did that event. But I just wanted to say hello and make sure y'all, you know, having fun.
Well, I'm glad you did. How have you liked that new setup so far?
The kickstand I love. The front wheel I'm kind of getting used to. It's kind of awkward for me, but, you know, it's just going to take a little getting used to that. The I haven't had any trouble out of the burners. And then the burners actually get hotter quicker, even though I got three burners instead of the two IBTU ones. They get hotter quicker, but I haven't got real good at regulating them yet. I'm kind of like starting over. you know, a vendor that's been doing this since 2009, and now I'm, you know, trying to learn how to regulate my heat.
And see, they say you can't teach old dog new tricks, so you can.
But, yeah, it's getting better. I mean, it's going to take a couple more times because I haven't done any of my street events because, like, well, Friday night I did the fireworks. Saturday morning I did the estate sale. Saturday night I worked 12 hours at my regular job. So by Sunday morning I was kind of give out.
Wow. Well, I'm impressed. Yeah. I'm glad you did. You'll get used to those burners. I know that when we first started making carts, we used burners that were 75,000 BTU. And you're talking about heat and recovery. You could scream through some water. You could dump ice cold water in there every 5 minutes and have it boiling in minutes. It was awesome. But the problem is that too many people don't regulate that, and they explode their hot dogs 4 minutes into it. And so we ended up going with more burners with less BTU, and it does take some getting used to. I had to get used to the same thing. My cart that's sitting here is three burners, and it's a conversion. You know, I converted it over.
Yep. It's taken some getting used to, but the three burner system actually to me seems like it gets hotter quicker. But it's harder for me to regulate it because the burners are closer to the pans, and
gotcha.
It's just something I've got to, kind of got to get used to. But all the improvements on the cart were just, I mean, fantastic. It's, it got home, and I didn't actually mean to be as busy as I was Friday night. I didn't actually expect to be the only food vendor for the whole city fireworks, and I was the only food vendor, and there was only two of us that were selling drinks.
Wow. And,
good for you.
And it was a free event, so, you know, everybody and their brother came out, and then probably about 50% of the customers already knew me and were my regular customers. Anyway, I had one of the lawyers came up, and he had to stand in line for like 5 minutes to wait for me to cook him a sausage dog, because I just couldn't cook them fast enough. And but we had a good time. It's, you know, all these people that say you can't do it, ain't never could do anything. And you know, you just got to take that step. And even if you start out with a used car or you know, with a used steam table, you know, or whatever you got to do to do it, you know, you got to take that first step.
Well, you're exactly right, but I appreciate you coming on and always willing to help us, Mike.
Yeah. And you realize Jason also has one of those T-shirts. So when you go to Pennsylvania, y'all can look like twins.
It's the worst end of that deal.
All right, let me get off this phone. I just wanted to holler at
you. Us together, we're going to ruin your good name. Have a good one, Michael. Thanks for joining us.
Y'all have a good night.
You bye-bye. Bet. Caller, last four of 3394, you are live on Hot Dog Vendor Radio and Street Food Vendor TV.
Hey, Ben, this is Ben.
Hey.
Hey, I had a question. I see that you're a smoker also.
No.
I'm a smoker. I'm getting ready to go into the business. So how do you go about doing that? I know people despise smokers a lot.
A lot of people despise smoking smokers. I never smoked out at my cart. I'd move over to my vehicle and smoke. And, you know, we called it hot boxing in high school, you know, where you suck it so hard your fire on the end is, you know, like that long. So I don't think that you'll have any issue with it as long as you don't sit there and hold it and, you know, and make their hot dog.
Yeah.
If you
had my issue of thinking of a hot dog. Somebody walks up and wants to buy a dog, you throw it out real quick, but you still have that, you know, smell on you.
Well, if somebody pulls up, I mean, you're going to have more of a hot dog smell than smoke, and so that's not what they're going to notice. And if they're getting that close, they need to be different. But I would definitely, if they see you smoking, like you're standing back and you're smoking, I would always come up, wash your hands while you're greeting them, and make it a point to do that. Otherwise, you could cause yourself. It just looks nasty as hell, and I wouldn't do it.
Yeah,
I don't,
that was my main worry.
If we were back in the 70s and 80s, you know, with Mel's Diner, you know, he's cooking scrambling eggs, and he fries up his damn eggs with ashes in it. it wouldn't hurt anybody, but it sure looks like piss.
Yeah, if you wash your hands in front of them, it'll mean everything to them, and then it'll be like, okay, it's all cool.
Yeah,
I was just thinking down here at the beach, Ben, you know, I got the enclosed cart, so I'll step outside to have a cigarette and whatnot. But it's like you can't smoke on the beach, so they all come out there by where I'm at to have their cigarettes. So I figured I'm just joining in with them.
Okay, yeah, that was my only question. I was wondering, I wondered if maybe you put on a patch for when you went out and work or whatever.
No.
No.
If I put on a patch, I'm still smoking.
That's a man right there, boy.
Oh. I'm devoted. I see we have Kyle Phillips on air with us. Kyle, how are you tonight? Can you see us, hear us? Kyle, can you hear me?
Hey, Kyle.
Hey, Kyle.
I don't know if he can hear us. Let me try something. I'll do what I did with Jason.
You still got Street Vendor on and needs to mute it and put this on.
Kyle, if you can hear us, if you have the live feed going, just turn it off, you know, mute it, and you can leave it up, but there is a delay. Let me see if I can. Okay.
Let me try.
I can hear you.
Okay. Kyle can hear us. How are you, Kyle?
Yeah. Kyle, if you can hear us, if you have the live feed going, just turn it off. You know, mute it. And you can leave it up, but there is a delay. Let's see if I can. Okay. Okay.
He's listening to the Street Vendor side.
Okay. I went over and did you get us muted, Kyle?
Nah, you have muted now, Ben.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. How are you, Kyle?
Okay.
Hey, Steven, we're getting a lot of feedback off of yours, too.
Okay, I went over and, did you get us muted?
Okay, I just muted those. If you're listening in, and you're watching the live feed over at streetfoodvendor.tv. Mute it. Otherwise, it's about 30 seconds behind us And so you're better off if you're joining us live. You got a separate link, and that is live. We can all sit here and talk to each other. But if you have that other feed up, you're going to get this. We're going to hear everything twice. And I like hearing myself, but not twice.
Not twice.
Some things are worth saying twice, but caller area code 24. I meant not area code. Last 42474. This is Ben. You're live on Hot Dog Vendor Radio.
Hey Ben. Hey Jason. How you guys doing?
Doing great.
Hey Roxanne.
Is this Roxanne?
Colorado.
All right. Yep. So go ahead and give us an update.
Just been, I kind of had to take a week off. I burned myself out there for a little bit, still working a full-time job and trying to do the cart like 5 days a week. So I took 4th of July off, which was...
Can you guys hear me?
Yeah, Kyle, we can hear you.
Yeah, now we can.
So, Roxanne, you took off the 4th of July?
Yeah, well, I work out at the scale, so they were off. So I took... We had the family coming out, so took a little mini week off and went back out and hit it. But... been just kind of chugging along, nothing, no stellar sales. I'm not having $600 2.5 hours, which would be sweet, but making a living on it, so that's cool.
That's good, as long as you're in the...
Are you still out at the truck scale?
Yep, still with those truckers.
Okay.
Roxanne, are you at
a... You know, if you miss one day, they start worrying about you or something, so that's pretty funny.
Hey, Roxanne? This is Bubba. Are you at a scale on the highway or at the scale at a truck stop?
I'm at the steel mill, the scale at the steel mill within.
Oh, at the steel mill. Okay, I got you.
Yeah, so I'm like on private property.
Well, that's you know. Is that working out pretty good?
Yeah. It's good. It's not great by any means, but it's a safe place, and mm-hmm. I like the customers and 2.5 hours in and out, you know, so it works for me.
Well, good.
Did have on Wednesday, I was wanted to tell people, you know, you check your tire pressure and you check your lug nuts and stuff, and I went to we're going down the scales on Wednesday, and it felt like my cart jerked a little bit on the truck, and I was like, that's weird. I stopped up the light, and then I started to pull away, and I saw my cart like ram into the back of my truck. That holds down your hitch mechanism, your locking mechanism. The nuts are off of there, so the whole thing fell off. You know?
It's not great.
Can't listen to my truck.
Safe place, and I like the customers, and 2.5 hours in and out, you know. So it
now I have a feedback on this end. That's weird.
I did that one day. I drove all the way home from Menards, which is about 10 miles. And when I got home, I go to take the cart off the back. I never locked it down.
Oh, man.
And trust me, that will never, ever happen again. I was lucky because I went over a couple railroad tracks. I always slow up for them because the thing will launch in the air anyways. But when I got home, I was like, that will never happen again. So now it's the first thing when it hits, it's locked.
There's a nut fell off, and so the whole damn thing, you know, bounced off. I have a big dent in the front end of my cart now. But
yeah.
I'm not too worried about that. I can fix that. So.
Well, Roxanne, are you trying some different things to increase your volume? Are you doing anything new to, like, even new locations?
You know, this is really a part-time job for me. I mean, I have a full-time job. It's kind of replacing a income we lost in the house.
I understand.
You know, so I can't. I mean, I did it. I worked like 21 days straight and had like 2 days off.
Yeah, that'll burn you out quick.
Not worth anything. Yeah.
Jason doesn't know anything about that.
Exactly. Well, I tend to, you know, I work night shifts and I don't get enough sleep, and it tends to make everybody crabby. Especially me, but
right.
So it's really just a part time, you know, something that the income pay some bills aren't getting stuff. So. But we are going to start doing breakfast 2 days a week coming this week. So just do something simple: cinnamon rolls, biscuits, or cinnamon rolls and breakfast burritos. So. because there's just a lot of those guys out there that come in the night before and get stuck there overnight and have no food or anything. So we're going to see how that goes for about a couple weeks and see if it's worth it or not.
Well, good. I'm glad you're still at it. What's that, Jason?
Yeah.
You can do biscuits and gravy. You know, cut the biscuits, throw them in a number three fry boat, pop the gravy on top, get them a fork. Well, that's a nice, easy breakfast.
Thinking doing biscuits and gravy or even just biscuits and gravy, definitely. You know, do the pancake mix, put the grill on there. You could throw your hot ones in your steam table there, too, so... Pancakes are, you know, cheaper than biscuits and gravy, actually, with the sausage and everything. So.
Oh, yeah.
But we're going to try that, you know, when we're out there for 2 days. Instead of being out there for 2.5 hours, we'll just be out there
right.
for like maybe six, and if it pays for stuff or not, you know. So.
We did pancakes.
I'm not looking for new locations or anything.
We did pancakes this Saturday, and they hold very well in the steam table. Especially if you put some foil down to block a large portion of the steam that would just pretty much melt them down. And we didn't have that many customers for breakfast. Menards told us it would be jam-packed, and it wasn't. But the few that ate it, that had my wife's pancakes, were just, they were like, wow, this is on a cart? I was like, yeah, it's on a cart. So it will work. Just put foil down on your steam table to block a lot of the steam.
Okay. And did you just use like syrup bottles, or did you put hot syrup on your card?
Say that again, what?
Did you just like use syrup in the bottles on the table, or did you put hot syrup on the table?
No. We just left syrup on the table because the sun was out. It was warming up anyways, and I didn't really want to put hot syrup on the cart just for the sake of trying to find the right size to do it and all that other stuff. And you know, the pancakes coming out of that steam table, if they've been holding, they're pretty hot, so you might want the cooler maple syrup to bring it down. But the butter melts real fast.
We're having fun. I mean, it's a good job. You know, it's you get better at it as longer you go, and then, you know, you're getting ready to go to work, and you lose your cart. So it's just every day is a new challenge sometimes, but it's all fun, though.
As long as you're having fun, that's it.
Nice comes with money in your pocket every day, too, so that's a good thing.
Yep.
That's always a good thing.
Yeah. Makes the fun even more fun.
If you're not doing that, you're doing something way wrong. But anyway, I just want to check in with you guys, say hey to you, Ben, Jason, and nice meeting you, Bubba. And I'll keep listening, okay?
I appreciate it. I'm glad you...
Hi, Roxanne.
Nice to meet you, too, Roxanne.
Nice to meet you guys.
All right. Bye-bye, Roxanne.
Have a good night, Roxanne.
All right, Kyle, can you hear me? Let me see. I don't have you muted.
Now it says you muted him.
Okay, now? He's
still muted.
Hey, Kyle, put your cursor over your face, and you'll see a little microphone come up. You might have muted yourself.
Yeah, I can hear you now.
Can you hear me?
Yes, sir. How are you tonight, Kyle?
I am wonderful. Yourself?
Doing wonderful. Well, did you have any questions for us, or did you just want to hang out and join the show?
No questions yet. Just learning.
Well, just feel free to jump in anytime you want.
Will do.
All right, caller, I tell you what, caller 9555, if you'll hang on just a second, I'll be back with you, and we'll take any calls or questions.
Hot Dog Saved My Life, the book. Everything you ever wanted to know about hot dog vending, and probably some things you don't, available at benscarts.com/book. Why spend $100 or more dollars when you can get it all for less than $30?
Less than $30.
BensCarts.com/book. Get it, read it, and discover how you can cash in and change your life for good. BensCarts.com/book. It's Sunday night, and you're listening to the all-new HDVR Hot Dog Vendor Radio Show with Ben. Call in at 424-258-9364. Press 1 to go live and ask Ben a question. You wanted the best? You got it. You're listening to HDVR Hot Dog Vendor Radio.
A whole awesome nervous thing.
Good.
This is Slick Willie Johnson from New York, and you'll be grooving live with the Hot Dog and some Man on HDVR, Hot Dog Vendor Radio. Come on, dog,
let's take a got a question about hot steamy buns. Call Ben at 424-258-9364 for the latest tips and tricks in the world of wieners. That's 424-258-9364. Press 1 to talk live, one-on-one to Ben. Sunday night, 8:30 Eastern Standard Time. HDVR, hot, steamy buns.
We now return you live to Hot Dog Vendor Radio with Ben.
Hey, folks, thanks for joining us. You're listening live to StreetFoodVendor.tv and Hot Dog Vendor Radio. We are live on the air, got lots of guests and lots of people listening tonight. I think it's the busiest night in our history as far as a number of people listening. Caller with the last four of 9555, you are live on Hot Dog Vendor Radio.
Hey, Ben, this is Jimmy's Hot Dog Man in Maryland. How you doing?
Man, you know what I was thinking about today? How are you?
Oh, man, I'm doing wonderful, man. A lot has happened since I've been on the air a couple of weeks, man. I've been on a roll. Just come on to ask a question and share a whole lot of stuff with people that might want a few ideas to help their business grow.
I'd love it. Go ahead and shoot.
All right, 4th of July fireworks. Did funnel cake for the first time. Small investment of $250 turns $700 in less than an hour and a half.
Oh, so my gosh.
You want to consider adding to your for events only. I suggest not doing it during your regular vending, but you got an event and, you know, a teenage son or daughter wants to make a quick $150, funnel cakes is the way to go.
Unreal.
Are you doing already fried, Jimmy, or were you frying them on site?
No, don't do the frozen. They don't taste as good. Nope. Restaurant Depot's got an excellent batter. Costs about $7.40 a bag. You get 36 funnel cakes out of it. At $5 a whop, you can probably do the math. But the batter is Carnival quality batter. It's real sweet, real easy to mix. Just mix it with water. All the eggs and stuff is in there. Virtually, you go to a restaurant equipment store to buy the propane stand and a big pot. Do about 3 funnel cakes at one time. Confectioner's sugar, the mold, and you're in business, man. It didn't take much.
You know what?
About $250 for the equipment. Huh. And it's already paid for itself in 1 hour.
You know, I should make this number 10 on the list, but there are some vendors that have gotten started in the business by doing things that were legal without health department approval and cost less to get in. Rob, one of our vendors that used to come on the show a lot about a year ago, he found out that in North Carolina, a vendor didn't have to have a license through the health department, just a business license is all he needed, a regular, normal $35 business license, and he could set up on property that he had permission and do funnel cakes.
Wow.
Yeah, I mean, pretty much it's the same thing in this area. You can start off with cotton candy, lemonade, funnel cakes, and ice cream with just a temporary permit. You don't need a food handler's license, food safety managers to do those. It's when you get in the hazardous 2 and the class hazard 3 section that is highly regulated. All those are considered class 1. I tell you, man, I just tell you, just so many things. Here's another example. Restaurant Depot's got a 3-gallon freezer that you can buy for $89. I bought it the other day, tried it yesterday at the event, and knocked it out the park. And what it is, you put it in your freezer for 8 hours, and there's a gel inside the walls of this freezer. You take a 3-gallon container of vanilla ice cream, put it in there, and hold it at 40 degrees for 8 hours.
What? Wait, back up.
I mean, I sold one scoop for $1, two scoops for $4, man. I'll tell you, that thing was empty.
What is this? Where? Tell us again where to get this. You said Lowe's?
Restaurant Depot.
Restaurant Depot is selling what they call a ice cream freezer.
Wow.
And it's the same size as a 3-gallon container of ice cream. You put it in your regular freezer overnight for 8 hours. There's a gel inside the wall, so you don't need any electricity or anything like that. And what happens is the gel freezes in that wall, and then you just pop a 3-gallon container of ice cream in there, or less. You can put a gallon container in there and just scoop ice cream all day long. It keeps it cold for up to 8 hours, 8 to 10 hours.
Now, wow. Jimmy, your health department doesn't make you have a water bath for the scooper?
No, because it was NFS scooper. You know, I had the little milkshake container you can buy for $3 to put cold water in there to keep rinsing your scoop. And help. I did it yesterday, and it was 98 degrees here in D.C., Maryland area. And the health inspector came up, inspected me, and told me have a nice day. So I was completely legal.
Wow.
Yeah, see, here we can't do it unless you have a running bath.
Business, you know, when you're doing events or you know, like I'm going out to my regular vending spot tomorrow since I bought this thing on Friday, and I'm going to try it with a 1-gallon container and see how they like it. So once I mean, a gallon costs you about $6. So, I mean, you can probably make $40 off of 1 gallon.
Wow.
Quick idea that you don't need a whole lot of equipment and extra people to do while you're serving dogs, you know.
Could you hold like ice cream or popsicles on a stick in that thing?
You could, but it's really designed for a 3-gallon container to fit down there snugly. The gel, I don't know how it would do with popsicles, but you can get for popsicles, you can do a small cooler with dry ice in there, if you will, for popsicles. That's pretty easy. I mean, yeah. They have Italian ice they sell, a little push-up Italian ice. I did those and put them in my regular fridge that Ben put on my cart, and that did pretty well. But if you don't keep your refrigerator frozen, they'll tend to melt quicker and turn slushy. So that's the key. You got to keep that refrigerator pretty cold.
Right.
But, you know, the other thing is lemonade, too. I know, Ben, I told you the last conversation we had, lemons are about $30 a crate in this area. You can geez. Well, they are pretty expensive here. Even on the farms, they're about $23, $25 a crate.
Right.
So I told you, you know, I've been doing pretty good with that Simply Lemonade. It's a trick for the vendors. If they don't want to squeeze lemons and mix sugar, get that right tartness to sweetness mixture, go to Sam's Club and get the Simply Lemonade. It's $3.88 for a gallon, or it's 2 half-gallon bottles. Pour it in there, and you can... Yeah, that's another $500 or $600 off of lemonade yesterday. 10 gallons went in 3 hours.
Oh, my gosh.
There you go.
Yeah.
I've thought of doing that with the lemonade mix because we don't have it fresh yet.
You can help. Just enhance your business. Another thing you can do, I don't know if you have a Rita's in your area, but Rita's will sell you their Italian ices by the 5-gallon bucket. And if you got a son or daughter you're trying to bring along in the business to get them, you know, going and interested, you can buy three of those containers of Rita's, and Rita's sell out just like that. I mean, Rita's Italian ice and soft custard is
hey, yeah. Hey, Jimmy, we're going to have to talk about getting you on a chill trick down there.
Yeah, for real.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, with the Rita's, all you need is a table, some cups, you know, some scoopers, and you're in business. I mean, that's just a simple setup for anybody who wants, like you said, Ben, quick starters to get into the business, make some money where they can buy a hot dog. You know?
Yeah, but see, we get you on a chill track, Jimmy. You're going to have a freezer and a refrigerator, so depending on what you're doing with an event, you can either run it as a fridge or a freezer, and you got solar panel on the roof that's...
Yeah.
Triple charging the battery, so you have an actual deep freezer.
Company came out there yesterday, and they had those 5-gallon containers you buy at Home Depot, the orange ones. and they had their Italian ice down in those containers, and I mean, they rocked and rolled with just that. They didn't really, maybe they might have some gel packs around it, containers to keep them cold.
Yeah.
But you know,
the Italian ice can be at a much higher temperature, where your hard ice cream needs to be at about 10.
Right.
Stuff needs to be about 30. Because you're actually turning that, because with water ice, the flavor actually goes from the top to the bottom. So you actually have to churn it to bring the bottom back to the top and then smooth it out.
Yeah, I mean, you know, for any of these vendors out there, I know you get these questions all the time. How do I get in the business? I don't have any money to start up. Well, these are just quick hitters. This is an example. I was at an event 3 weeks ago, and a lady, all she did was funnel cakes. No toppings, just powdered sugar, and she was charging $5. It was an 8-hour event. At the end of the day, she made $1,200. And that's no joke. And she was just doing it by herself with no help. So
the other thing you could do, Jim, with those funnel cakes is pie topping, you know, peach, apple, cherry, blueberry, chocolate, whipped cream, all easy stuff, cheap stuff, but you can, you know, upcharge for it.
Yeah, yeah, you can add a dollar. I mean, with my lemonade, I bought a half a gallon of syrup, strawberry syrup from Restaurant Depot, mixed it with the right water concentrate, brought a bag of frozen strawberries, poured the strawberries in there, and then if they wanted strawberry lemonade, I just took a scoop of that mixture, poured it in the glass, and charged $2 more.
Yeah.
For strawberry lemonade. Yeah, it really worked. It was a big hit. So, just a few things I wanted to share with you guys.
Well, you know, I'm glad you did, because that's a huge deal to be able to, one, start. I'm glad you called in, Jimmy, because it reminded me about starting in when you have, you can't do a cart, and you could do a funnel cake, or you could do ice cream, or you could. You can go to Jason and get an ice cream bike. He even has some older models that you can get a little cheaper and get started at least.
You got John Cavanaugh for financing too. We forgot exactly. To talk about him.
Yeah, that's good you brought that up, Ben, because in this area, one of the jurisdictions that I've been in, the only person that can set up on the street at all is an ice cream vendor. No food trucks are allowed to bend Monday through Friday, just special events only, except ice cream. So if you have one of those ice cream push trucks, and people might want to check this in their jurisdiction about the certain laws about street vending. You know, they call it right away or whatever, or corner or whatever. And then you only can do ice cream trucks. So really, I can go in there with that little ice cream thing and establish a route without any bother from the health department.
Yep, that's one of the benefits of it. It's, you know, you're selling novelty or prepackaged stuff, so you know, no commissary needed, no hand sink. You know, the markups are great on the ice cream, you know, and even if somebody else is doing ice cream, just this kind of weather, you could run around and just do water out of it, run it as a refrigerator, and, you know, probably do really well just that.
Yeah, speaking about that, I ran to a guy at the beginning of the summer. He had a little shopping cart, you know, the kind you see the old lady pull around?
Oh, yeah.
Two-wheeler. And inside his shopping cart, he had a cooler, and he had 1 3-gallon container of Italian ice. He had these little 2-ounce cups and was selling $1 a scoop, just walking around the street, just selling Italian ice. So, I mean, there's many ways for vendors to get started in this business.
One of our events, we saw a guy with a shopping cart from a grocery store, one of the metal shopping carts. Across the top of it, he had plywood with a stack of pretzels. And then he had a hibachi running in the front of the cart, and he'd take pretzels and put it on the grill. People were buying them. We got one that tasted like crap. I think he used lighter fluid to start the grill.
Wow. Hey, Ben, I had a question for you before I go. I don't want to take up all the time. I sent you an email trying to get that contract from Smoking Hot Dogs, and I got a return message from you saying that it would, the PDF or the file would follow for me to download. It never came through. Because I got a customer that wants a contract.
Okay.
In September. And how could I access that?
Well, I tell you what, Jimmy, if you'll email me again at ben@benscarts.com, I don't know where you were sending it, but it may not have been me that answers it. I've got a daughter now that's trying to help me answer emails, And so if she sees that it's something, you know, I've given her all these common, you know, replies, and that may have been what happened. If you'll just email me tonight, I'll make sure to check it, and I'll send you a direct download link.
Hey, is she reading the tips tonight?
Do what?
Is she reading the tips off tonight?
Yeah. No, she didn't want to do the tips tonight. That's a different daughter doing the some of my emails. But Kaylee that did the tips last week, she wanted to go to the skating rink tonight, and so she went to the skating rink. Her older brother took her.
You got yourself a whole workforce there, Ben.
If I could get them to do a damn thing, it'd be good.
Yeah, probably.
Jimmy, I apologize. I just didn't catch it. And had I caught it, I'd have sent it to you. Just send me an email tonight, and I'll get it to you.
Format it. Yeah. I followed the instructions by giving her a like on her Facebook page, and then I went to the store and clicked on vendor forms, and then came up and told me what to do. That's the one I followed. So
okay,
I got a reply from you saying that I could download the PDF right now, but when I wouldn't let me click on it. So
okay,
I don't know what happened.
Just send me something, and I'll get you a different link.
It was probably Bubba's fault. We'll just deduct it from his paycheck this week. No problem, Jimmy. Don't worry about it. We'll get it out to you.
Have at it. I don't need the money. I'm independently. Well, no, I'm not. Yeah. There's a funny thing that happened this week, and here's a great story. My wife, we're sitting there Saturday, and it's at the slowing down. It's around 3 o'clock or so, and it's starting to slow down. She says, you know, I've only had one dream in my life, to have a roof over my head, food to eat, and clothes on my back. I never wanted to be rich. And I went, well, sweetie, you're living the dream.
Hey, Ben, a quick follow-up to the 501c3s. You told me to investigate that. Yes, you can get under a charity certificate and be a part of that charity. They call them sub-charities.
Right.
So vendors need to check their local jurisdiction laws about that. All you got to do is go down to the environmental health or the department that issues the license, and they will tell you if you can come under another charity. And usually what you do is, once that a charity agrees to allow you under their certificate, you bring a copy of that certificate to the health department, and they will give you a non-exempt status, which means some jurisdictions will give you your license for free or at a reduced rate and let you set up in places where they don't let anybody else set up at. So I would encourage vendors to check their local laws for their health department or the ones that issue the license, the zoning department or whatever. So I'm working on a charity now. If I can get this license, I can get my license free for the whole year.
Oh, wow. That will be fantastic.
Yeah, so I know we're all in different states and different jurisdictions, and I give you an example. In Maryland, you know, we're broken down all these counties. Well, Carroll County, I had a vendor yesterday that was doing just potato chips and soda at this event, and she wanted to get in the hot dog business. They turned her hot dog cart down because she didn't have commercial burners. She didn't have she had those rails that you see in a regular gas grill, the long kind.
Yeah.
So she took a picture of my car, and I gave you your website so she could contact you about commercial burners. But I don't know. I think this county, there's no hot dog vendors at all in this county anywhere. So I think at first they were telling her that she had too many pans, and now it's the wrong burner. So I think they're just screwing with her to keep her setting up.
Well, it probably is, but I do know some manufacturers. I know two manufacturers that use those cheap burners, like out of, you know, like a Walmart grill. You just go get their fake stainless steel, and they put those in. It shouldn't stop her, because having a commercial burner or a residential burner shouldn't matter, and it's probably not in the code. You ought to send her to the link learnhotdogs.com/liar, and the article is called "If Their Lips Are Moving, They're Lying."
Yep.
And right. Usually, so if you ask,
in writing.
Yeah, exactly. See it in writing is the gist of the article.
Yeah.
Because it probably doesn't exist.
Just tell her to play really stupid and just say, listen, I want to make sure I'm following this, you know, the right way and get the right burners. Can you show me in the SOP what the description is on the burner so I can make sure I meet all your requirements. And when they can't show it to you, then you can question as to why these burners don't, you know, don't work for them.
Right. Usually it's a matter of opinion and it's bullshit.
Yeah, that's what I told her. I told her, you're screwing with you. They don't want you to sell in the county. You know, I think, when I first got in the business last season, I was battling this one county about the cart not being NFF, and they said that I couldn't get a license and all that, and they're still holding up that stand. Their premise is, you know, well, the state may say this, but we're allowed to be more stringent than the state. So this is our rule and regulation. There's nothing you can do about it, virtually.
Yeah, but Jimmy, you can go back on them because NSF is not allowed to certify a cart.
That's true. Yeah, Ben and I went back and forth and sent them the regulations that we had. I mean, we went back and forth with these people, and they're really being stubborn about it.
I believe it almost take a lawsuit.
It could be made out of plywood, and they would approve it because it's an open cart and it's not NFS certified stainless steel. They will not approve my cart. So it is just stubbornness on their part, and they will not, you know, relinquish. So
you know that almost be worth a call to IJ just to irritate them. Hold their feet to the fire.
I thought about buying one of Ben's little dog cars with the bicycle wheels on it because the county next to me, it's a city, really. They have a big town center and a big courthouse, and they make you move from every hour from block to block, and you cannot return to the same block in the same day.
Good God.
Oh, yeah.
You know that's been challenged in federal court and lost.
Really?
Yeah, that's an illegal law. It's a violation of your Bill of Rights.
Sure it is.
They cannot do it. It's your right to work, and they create these fake ass restrictions that they put on you that you have to move every 15 minutes or you can never be still unless there's an active customer at your cart, and those are illegal, and every time they've been challenged, they've lost. And usually the city will back down before it ever goes to court. But it has been to federal court, and Institute for Justice is the one that took them there.
Wow.
Yeah. This place is a gold mine, too. There's no food vendors at all in this jurisdiction. And, you know, it
might be worth a call to IJ, Jimmy.
Yeah, I'd call Institute for Justice.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, you know, it's a ton of restaurants. What it is a big town center with a movie theater and courthouses all centered around that. It's got a ton of restaurants. Everything's from Chick-fil-A to Potbelly. And these restaurant owners are buddy-buddy with the city manager and the mayor. You know, I went around with them, too. But by the same token, you know, the jurisdiction I'm in is very lenient. All they require me to do is have a county license, and they give me a city license, sight unseen, no inspection of the car, nothing like that. And I even do burgers now on my grill.
Good for you.
Oh, yeah, I mean, you know, I guess, you know, one way is bad, the other way is good. What can you say?
Double-edged sword.
I know. I learned from Ben. If you don't take the first no you hear, you keep pushing, you keep prodding, you'll eventually get there.
That's true.
Yep.
Hey, Jimmy, are you still on schedule to do that event for Tekla for me?
Yeah, that's the one I need the contract for. Tekla I sent them two menus, and they chose the first menu, which is regular dogs, Nathan's, and spicy hair smokes, drinks, and chips. All you can eat for 4 hours.
All right. If you have any issues there, just give me a call,
So they want a contract, and that's the final phase. So once I get this contract to them, they're going to sign it and email it back to me, and we're set for September.
All right. Well, if you need me, just call me.
I sure will. I might have to get one of them stolen bicycle cart, ice cream cars from me.
Well, I was willing to bring it down for that day or something for you. We'll figure something out.
I stole the panel for my hot dog cart so I can keep my freezer running without using the generator.
Yep. Yeah.
You can do that?
Yeah. It runs off the solar, and if there's no solar or no sun, you know, even on a cloudy day, you're going to get some activity out of the solar panel, but you have the backup of the two batteries. get almost 20 hours a run just out of the battery. So, you know, you're good for a day, you know, or an event like that.
Yeah, so you mean to tell me I can put that on the top of my bread box on my hot dog cart and run my freezer off of it?
Well, you'd have to dismantle and take it apart. I mean, you got the solar, you know, controller and all that kind of stuff wired up. I mean, give me a call this week. We can try and work something out for you. We'll figure something out.
Yeah, I was going to say, yeah, I'm going to have to call you about that one because...
Yeah, I'll put Bubba on it.
Yeah, that kind of weather, I got to, you know, I'm using about almost a gallon of gas a day keeping my freezer, you know, my food cold. So,
man, what kind of generator are you running?
I got a little Honeywell 2200, that small portable one.
Pretty man, I do, mine runs 4 hours a day, and I do about 7 gallons a week.
Yeah, that's about right. Well, I do less than 7. I'm using about 3. But I thought about your ice cream cart. I said, well, that, if you can do solar power for that, maybe you can put it on a hot dog. There you go, Ben. There's a new accessory for you. Solar panels for your hot dog cart.
We've actually got a blog article about that with pictures of a guy that did that, and he runs everything off solar power. Well, he backs up everything with solar power.
To an inverter. Doesn't Brian run solar? I think Brian runs solar.
Yeah, I think Brian has bubbles. Solar too. Yeah.
Wow. Yeah, I tell you, Jason, we'll talk about that, man, because I don't know what it takes to, how many pounds you need, you know, to run something like that. But I would definitely be interested in adding to my cart because.
We'll get you a cart for that thing for the dogs on in September or something. Even if you just need it for a day or something, we'll figure something out. I'll have Bubba come out here. He can tow it down for you and set it up and hang around and drive it back to me.
I can put it on the back of my motorcycle and tow it up there.
See, there you go. Well, see, Bubba's wife now knows how to run a car, so Bubba got all kinds of free time now.
Yeah, I'm just loaded with it. Just loaded with it.
I tell you, another thing I'm working on, Ben, is working on getting a beer license to serve these hot dogs, man. These motorcycle shows are phenomenal, and they drink beer like crazy.
You know, so Pocono does good with that. Pocono hot dogs. You ought to holler at him. He's on Facebook, and yeah. I mean, he's even got a keg strapped to his cart for his golf course events.
That's what I wondered. One keg and a tub of ice, man. You can roll all day. Beers and hot dog go together like pizza and pepperoni, I guess.
But I'm looking at the right insurance rider.
Today asked me that. Getting a beer license.
Yeah, I mean, I did a bicycle motorcycle show yesterday. Set up at 10 o'clock. 1:30, I was sold out.
There you go.
And that was over 200 meals. So.
And what I loved about Pocono, he was on the show about a year and a half ago, and he's been vending for over 20 years. And this man, he doesn't ask for permission. He goes to a golf course, and on certain days, and he's got the beer keg and everything, and he's licensed, but he has no permission to be there. But he's been there so long, everybody thinks he's supposed to be there.
Oh, wow. We got a ton of golf courses around here. Matter of fact, we got Congressional with Tiger Woods as his tournament app. So, yeah, we got a ton of golf courses around here. I'm going to have to try to just show up. Start selling hot dogs, huh?
Yeah, he
they make that Cushman cart with the drink well and steam table and all that, you know?
Yeah, we did one for a customer. They sent us an old Cushman cart, and we modified it with all the stuff.
That's like that Harley-Davidson that John Izzo does, that trike where they put the push cart on the back of it.
Yeah.
Seen that.
So you got to get that done and then haul a big dog with the cart with the trike.
Let's put Bubba on that.
Why not?
Bubba, get on that.
I'm on it.
Well, folks, we gotta get going. We've got a whole bunch of tips that were sent in this week. And, Jimmy, you're welcome to stay on. If you think of anything else, jump right in there.
Okay.
But we've got a ton of tips that came through this week. But I do want to finish the questions, if I can find what I did with them. The the gentleman that emailed, I want to run through these real quick. He says, third for electricity, I was thinking of a deep cell marine battery. He asked me what kind. I don't have a kind that I would recommend unless one of y'all do. Just any deep cell battery.
Depends on drawing and what the inverter is, you know?
Yeah. And some inverters, you know, the smart inverters, that it doesn't really matter what you hook to it. It can figure out and change the amperage requirements based on what its draw is. Do you use a cash register? We've talked about this before on the show. If you look up SalesView, SalesVU, it is phenomenal, and I use it, and Jason uses it, and I don't know who else uses it, but
Corey's getting ready to switch, I think.
It is fantastic, and you can do it on your iPod, iPhone, iPad, iPod. Android. It just doesn't matter. If it has an I in the front of it, it'll work on it, and it is.
I'll work on the Android too, Ben.
Yeah, it'll work on the Android now. They added that. And I haven't seen that on an Android, but it's all the same software, and it's free software. It's better than a cash register. It's smarter than a cash register, and it will keep up all your books, and it's made for vendors. It's made for food industry. You can't get a better piece of software, and it's free. So I tell you what, if you try it and don't like it, I'll give you your money back.
What's the name of that again?
The doctor from Bubba's paycheck.
I thought it was free.
SalesView, SalesVU. Yeah, there's no capital gimmicks, Bubba. It's 100% free software. You can download it on iTunes. SalesVU.
Hey, Bubba, I did a special this week you might like. I did, you buy the first dog for the cost of two, you get the second one absolutely free.
I saw that, and I started laughing down here so hard in the basement. My wife goes, what the heck is going on? I just go, Jason just got it. And I told her to her, and she goes, well, that doesn't sound like a deal at all. I go, yes, it is. It's a great deal.
Well, one of my customers gave me an idea. We're going to do 20% off your change or no change Friday.
No change Friday.
I was an asshole this week. I had a lady call me, and she was asking me question after question, and I was patient, and I answered them, and all of it was there on the free training videos. The first six would have given her every answer she wanted. And she told me her computer.
I read everything on your website, but can you answer this for me?
Do y'all sell hot dog carts, right? Yeah. And I was going nuts, you know. And well, anyway, we hung up, and she calls right back, and she goes, "I forgot to ask you this, you know, do you sell carts or whatever it was?" And I said, "I tell you what," I said. She goes, "I saw that you did, you know, personal like consultations," and she goes, "I'd like to do that." And I said, well, here's the link. And, well, my internet's down, and my neighbor's chicken's having puppies and whatever else. And I said, well, I tell you what, if here's my private line. Call me the second Tuesday of next week. And she goes, okay. And I haven't heard from her since, but we haven't made it to the second Tuesday of next week yet. So it'll be interesting to see at what point she figures that out and calls me back. Cussing me, but I'm sure.
tell her you got an opening for 13-13-14.
Yeah, there you go.
Let's see here. We've got. Also, I must say, let's see. As far as cart goes, blah blah blah. Which reminds me, what is normal shipping time? Shipping time 7 to 10 days. But that was his questions. I do want to run through these tips, and get these done. Let's see here. Okay, and somebody during the show has sent me pictures and everything of their cart and wants a, not really a critique, they just want some advice on some things, and so I'll be putting out either a video or I will put out a blog article with it if they give me permission to do so. Corey Lawrence, and I don't know him, but he sent in... instead of using funnels, spoons, or pouring from a big opening, we just cut a triangular shape in the top of the safety seals on a lot of products instead of removing the whole seal. Squeeze it right into your bottles with no mess and in no time.
Booyah!
I like that.
That's what I have on every one of mine. It's got a safety seal.
Bubba, you know what? I tell you what, we've got Kyle listening in, and Kyle, I'm going to be listing off all these tips, and at the end of the show, you've got to decide which tip you thought was best, and that person's going to win their choice of a dog sled, the book, or a set of chip clips.
That's right. It's on Kyle.
Oof.
So, Kyle, it's all on your head, and we'll give them your email so they can cuss you out later.
Baptism by fire, Kyle.
Yep. Happy Jack sent in, always provide a warm bun for your customers. It makes no difference if you toast or steam them. Take the time to properly prepare them before serving. It brings out the flavor of the bun and builds a foundation of taste to your creation. If you are serving buns right out of the bag, I challenge you to try warming them. I think you will start to see an increase in sales. Absolutely. If Crystal's or White Castle didn't steam their buns, it would be a shit sandwich. And they taste good because they're steamed. And that's the deal. It's period it. It's good because it's steamed. We're serving premium ingredients in a bun. Why ruin it by a crappy bun? So great advice, Happy Jacks. John Cavanaugh, never heard of this guy either. I have a bug on my head. I have a
from the Matrix.
He's got three tips for us. Never streak through a herd of rhinos with a bullseye taped to your rump. If you must attend a Weight Watchers convention, do it with flair. Paint yourself with Hershey's and holler, "Don't eat the chocolate man." Never ask a Tennessee hot dogger to explain the definition of the word inbred. Where I put my dog, or my cousin's sleepover, or what is my middle name. Oh my gosh, I could only read those if I was from Tennessee, so I would recommend having, this is somebody else, I would recommend having all of your accounts posting in unison. He's talking about your social media accounts, such as your Twitter, Facebook, website, and other social media accounts all have to date accurate info. Also, throw out a recognition to your faithful customers online. This comes from Andrew at Super Dogs, Super Hot Dogs.
Hootsuite.
That's really good. You said
awesome.
Hootsuite?
Hootsuite, HOOTSUITE. It's an app for Android and iPhone. It allows you to post to Facebook and Twitter in one, and also schedule date and time.
Okay.
So you know how I do the holiday every day? Like today was the International Day of the Nerd.
Right.
Well, that comes out at 8:55 every morning. When I'm slow, I go on, pick my holidays for the week, set them, book them for 8:55 in the morning, or schedule them, and bam, they're done.
Okay. Well, that was a great tip, Super Hot Dogs. That's S-U-P-A. I like that name.
Super.
Super. Customers eat with their eyes and noses first. Today, we will talk about their noses. You always want pleasing smells coming from your cart. You won't believe just how far the smells from your cart will carry. To help entice customers to have a hot dog, it's a common practice among doggers to flavor their cooking water. It may be steam or boiling, but try this little trick of the trade and see how it works for you. Slice up an onion or a few cloves of garlic and add them to your cooking water. The great smells will carry for blocks, and your customers will comment on it when they purchase a hot dog. Another good one, and that was from Happy Jack. He goes on the next day to tell me, yesterday we talked about appealing to customers through their noses. Today we're going to talk about appealing to their sight. I can remember, even as a kid, that my Uncle Hamp's hot dog joint, every hot dog he made looked the same. There was never a messy bun or anything out of place. He treated every hot dog like a fine steak and made sure he served it that way. Customers eat with their eyes first. Make it pleasing to them and they will return. Happy Jacks. I always loved, you know, he makes a good point, because when I give out a hot dog, I hate having to wrap it all the way because I don't want it to mush my creation. Especially if you've done a nice, pretty chili cheese dog or something, or a slaw dog, once it's rolled all the way up. So sometimes if they're standing there and I'm making several, I'll kind of make a boat out of it and I'll pinch it loosely at the top so that when they open it, they see this beautiful hot dog instead of looks like you just bought it at Sonic.
Right.
Next one is from Mustard Seed Grill. Don't be a victim of small thinking and small believing. Maintaining high expectations for your business and its success. Expectations works a lot like a lighthouse does for ships. If the lighthouse is on and burning bright, a ship can navigate into harbor in the roughest of storms. If you turn off the lighthouse, the ship must drop anchor and wait until light comes back so it will know the way to navigate into port. Keeping your expectations high will motivate you to do what it takes to make it work. Try new things, continually educate yourself, always look for how to improve. Believing you can do it is more than half the battle. Keep your expectations high until your ship comes in. Mustard Seed Grill. That was a good one. I like motivational stuff because sometimes we all know these things, but sometimes it helps to hear them. And always be aware of your hands and what they touch. Can't tell you how many vendors I've seen playing on their cell phones, taking money, waxing their cars, then picking up a bun with a bare hands. Yuck. That came from Sharon Eastman, and I'm not even going to attempt the last name. I want to, but
Pillow,
I'm
Pillow Willilaski.
Huh?
Pillow Willilaski. Am I right?
That's God bless you, Bubba. Hey, Kyle, you're keeping track, right?
Yeah, I'm writing this stuff down.
All right, I was going to say there's a test later.
Fall in love with what you are doing. You need to develop a passion for your hot dog business. It has to be right up there with the top five things in your life. Passion evokes enthusiasm, and your customers will see it clearly and will help you through any and all tough times on the job. Your business is you. If you're not committed, it will show, and your customers will not be drawn to your cart. Happy Jacks. You know, that's a really good point. There's times that my wife once told me I was in a pissed off mood.
Yep.
And she told me, she goes, you just need to stay home. There's no reason to go out there. You're going to do more harm than good. And so if you, and it's common to get these days, you will get these days, you've probably had them already, where you just can't, you can't find the gumph to go out there. Those are the days you keep your ass at home, get you some Jim Beam, Diet Pepsi, cigarettes or two, or 100, and enjoy life a little bit. That means you're overworking it, yep. And Happy Jack's right there.
You're not, like if you got a cart and you're selling hot dogs, you're not really selling hot dogs. You're selling yourself.
Yourself.
I mean, in a business like that where it's so personal, the hot dog is there. Yes, you've got a hot dog, and that's what they're paying for. But they are paying for its personality. And if you've got it and you're working it, the dog will always taste good, period, unless you've just really screwed it up.
Right.
They're buying the personality a lot of times. You know, like you said, they eat with their eyes first. They also eat with their ears. And if you're, you know, being a real stick in the mud or real asshole, they're just going to go, you know, you could serve them a gourmet elk dog.
Right.
And they're going to go, this was the biggest piece of crap I ever spent money on.
I had those on the menu today.
Elk dogs?
Yes. Elk with apple pear and port wine.
Wow.
I hate you.
All right, the next one comes from Rhonda at the Dog Paddler. Refrigerate your beverages to cool them down before putting them in coolers. It will make your ice last twice as long. Now, I had never heard this tip. This is smart. First weekend on the job, still working with the health department here in Michigan, and will be slinging dogs soon. I have started selling ice cream, water pop, and chips from my pontoon boat, Rhonda the Dog Paddler. I love the name. And I love the tip, refrigerate your beverages to cool them down before putting them in your cooler. I never did that. I guess I'm an idiot.
I would do it if I had more space.
Well, as you build up, you're going to end up with more fridges, more freezers. Sure. I've got four freaking deep freezers.
Yeah.
Because my closest, you know, I still go to Sam's, and my closest one is about an hour, 10 minutes.
Right.
So, yeah.
It definitely will, because if you put the worm in there, it just eats it alive at first.
Right.
Well, damn.
Okay. Let's see what we got here.
He's busier than a one-armed monkey.
Monkey with two peckers. It's Ben on HDVR, Hot Dog Vendor Radio.
Feeling lazy? Out of shape? Get off the f***ing couch. Go to benscarts.com and get the scoop on free training, top-notch accessories, link over to the radio show, and the blog. Plus, you can get Ben's tell-all book on how you can change your life forever.
Hot Dog Saved My Life.
It's all available at benscarts.com.
Be there. He's busier than a cucumber in a woman's prison. It's Ben on HDVR, Hot Dog Vendor Radio. He's cornier than an outhouse at a summertime family reunion. It's Ben on HDVR, Hot Dog Vendor Radio. It's Sunday night at 8:30, and you're riding a gravy train with biscuit wheels with a hot dog answer man, Ben, on HDVR, Hot Dog Vendor Radio.
All right, folks, we're back, and I thank you for humoring me a minute. We all needed a break. We're going crazy.
Is Rob Harper a redneck?
he's
trapped by you and...
He either is or he plays one in life.
He plays one on TV.
No, it's not too late. Let's see. How can I do this? Hold on just a second. We're going to have...
Hey, weren't we supposed to be doing an hour show?
Yeah, and if Supa Dogs hears me, I sent him a link. It's been a little while ago to get on the show. They may have had issues. I don't know. It should let up to 15 people if we so desire.
Yeah, but Bubba signed in 12 times.
Again.
Bumped Brian Shores out.
I tell you what. Do you want to go ahead and pick a winner there?
All right, Kyle. This is all you, bro.
Oof. I don't know. I got a toss up right now. I like the first one. I didn't catch the first guy's name, and I like Rhonda's tip as well.
First guy was Corey Lawrence from O'Doggies.
With the putting the triangles there in the top.
Yeah. That's a good one.
Yeah, I like that one.
Oh, well, it's up to you, bro. You pick.
I know.
I love laying this blame off.
I know. My first time on the show, and this is
Kyle. Kyle's like, man, I am never calling back into this damn show.
Pressure's on, Kyle. You walk in. Come on.
Yeah. Oh, and you know what? Just to make the pressure a little bit worse, Supa Dogs just joined us, and so he's watching.
Yeah, he's one of the tips. Come on, Kyle.
Oof.
You got your big boy haircut. Put on your big boy.
I like O'Doggies. I like that first tip.
Corey Lawrence,
winner. Corey, you know what to do. I don't know where you are tonight, but
he's having phone and internet trouble down there in Missouri. They have not had phone or internet all day, and his iPhone was just about dead. So he sent his apologies earlier. I told him no problem. We'll send Bubba down to beat him till morale improves. So, Corey, you need to email Ben, and inside the email in the body, you need to put your information, email, name, address, phone number, and whether you would like a dog sled, chip clip, or a book about hot dogs saved my life. It's pretty good. You should try it sometime.
And don't forget about me. I got that for you. So if I get contact on the fire, I want your backup.
Wait till we tell you, Kyle. Next week, you got to pick the contest.
Oh, great.
Well, I've decided I'm going to put my card up for sale on Ben's, and I'm just going to start charging for all this crap I got to do.
You're going to be busy this week. Your wife's going to have to sell the dogs. And
sweetie, I got to go.
Hey, don't forget, you got to drop that chill trike off down there to...
Over to Maryland, yeah.
Yep. So, you know, you can hang out for the day, eat hot dogs and ice cream, and then haul it on back up here to me.
I can do that.
Hey, let's talk to AJ real quick. AJ, can you hear us okay?
AJ? Hello?
Can you hear us?
Oh, he left. You scared him.
Scared him away.
Do you think, Kyle?
They know I'm there.
I'm not on the new guy.
Yeah.
Yes, you are.
I feel bad. It was Bubba's fault up until you joined.
Yeah. Next week, it's all on Kyle.
You took some pressure off Bubba. He can now breathe.
You know what? Next week, it'll be Bubba with the darn internet problem, and Corey will be back on.
That's what I told Corey. I texted him back. I said, you're just not coming on because you're afraid you're going to get hit with that contest.
Yeah, you saw Brian leave before we made it to the contest.
Yeah, wait till I text him.
Well, luckily, Kyle, or Sucker, as I like to call him.
Brian's like, I'm just listening to this on podcast from now on.
We appreciate it. AJ's back. AJ's back? Can you hear
us? Are you there, AJ?
He probably had the same problem as me when I first joined with the mic.
I'm going to check his... Let's see. No.
UCam 3?
Yeah, I don't know what that is.
Might be his webcam joining in.
It could be. Looks like the little insignia of it.
Yeah, I'm not sure. But either way, AJ, if you can hear us at any point and you want to sing or something, just go right ahead so we know you're listening. He's probably singing right now, a show tune.
Anybody going to San Antonio?
Look at Jason. He snuck off. While the camera went blank, he snuck off, but I can see that he's gone, and I can see his drums and the piano. Can you imagine the racket that can be made in that house?
No kidding. There's a room of noise. All the accoutrement.
That's right. Well, I don't have any more that I know of, and hopefully AJ will kind of stick around for a little bit, and we'll see if we can get AJ in here at some point. Let me check and see if we have anybody on the line holding. I don't see anybody there. Just waiting to talk. We had a good night, Jason. We did notice that you left. So that'll be
what they say about renting beer. Yeah, these 2-hour shows are killing me.
Grow up, you big baby.
You know, this 7 days a week, if Bubba would have showed up for work today and yesterday, I'd be, you know, fresh as a daisy, but now I'm kind of tired from this heat and this working.
I already learned, because it's hotter than heck here in Indiana, too, the humidity hit again. But that first week that I did 7 days out in the heat, I just went, I'm too old, too fat, can't do it. No matter how much money I need, I'm not going to do it, because... So we're taking Sundays and Wednesdays off so we can
kind of do our
Sundays and Wednesdays, man. Must be nice.
He's still here.
Yep,
I hear Jimmy. We do have a caller on. Maybe this is AJ on the call. Caller area, last four, 9086. 9086, you're live on Hot Dog Vendor Radio and Street Food Vendor TV. Hello?
Hello.
Almost there.
All right. That may have been an accidental pressed option one. I apologize if I picked up and you didn't want to be on live. AJ, can you hear us?
Nope.
Not getting nothing.
Nada.
He's not muted on my end. I don't know. AJ, I don't know what the deal is, but your UCam is up. We can see the picture of your UCam, but I just can't hear anything. But hold on. Maybe we got another caller here. Caller last four, 0330.
Hey, Ben, this is Steve-O.
Hey, how are you?
I was on the video feed earlier. I couldn't get my camera working.
Oh, okay.
But you surprised me so quick that I forgot the reason I wanted to get on the video feed was to thank you for the dog sled that was, you know, uniquely used as a cushion for my pants. You know, it was a bonus. I mean, you threw it in there as a cushion for my pants, not to, like, you know, slide from side to side.
Well, good. Well, good.
I appreciate that.
Yes, sir.
I just wanted to let you know that.
Well, I appreciate it.
Great to get back and listening to the show.
All righty. Well, thanks for calling in.
Steve, did you get done with your cart?
No, I... Unfortunately, I don't have a garage to work in. I got to work outside, and it rained the last week.
Bubba may have a garage.
Yeah, I got a garage.
He's going to be busy this week, but maybe next week.
Do that.
See, Bubba, it only takes one hand to drive, so you could be working on the cart with the other hand.
Yeah. I'm not even going to go about driving with one hand and working on a cart.
It needs to say Super Bubba.
In a world where Bubba does everything for us.
Slave boy.
Where's Rob Harper when you need him?
Oh, for real.
The weather's looking to be nice and sunny this week, so I'm looking to get it done this weekend. Or at least you can get your license by the end of the week.
Excellent.
Good.
Well, hopefully we can get some. I saw that he tried to get back online, and it didn't work again.
Yeah. Shows he's hit, and he's gone away. Come on, gone away.
Yeah.
We'll let Kyle close the show for us.
Yeah. Kyle, you go ahead and do the song.
What song?
Come on.
You didn't get the memo?
You got to start coming to the meetings, Kyle.
Kyle, we're going to have to dock this from your paycheck. It's going to show in your permanent record, Kyle. I'm sorry.
Thank God my paycheck's not taking the hit. Woo!
Well, Bubba, you're in the negatives.
We prepare for these on the second Tuesday of every week, and that's why they're so professional.
Man.
Oh, I did.
You know what we need to remind them guys of, Ben, is the cooldowns from Hotheads.
Yeah, go ahead. Let's do that.
I was just talking to Kevin Keller tonight and had to remind him of it. From Hotheads, and it's HEADZ, we get the cooldowns, which is COOLDOWNZ. And they're a bandana that you can drop in cold water. It takes about 20 minutes the first time you use them. It swells up, and you can wear it as a bandana across your head or around your neck. But during this hot weather, I wear one around my neck, keep one in the soda box, and I swap them out as I need them.
I think they actually sell those.
Like sweat.
I think they actually sell those at Lowe's.
The cooldowns?
Yep.
Yeah, Ace Hardware carries them sometimes, but you can call them direct. And get a box. I sell them, too, to my guys. I usually keep one or two in my ice box filled up, and I ask them, do you want one charged or do you want to take it dry? Nice option to be able to hand them something cold and, you know, let them pop it right on their neck and, you know, cool down.
And they work. They work good.
Awesome.
They'll keep you way cooler.
Yep.
If I wear a hat, I sweat, even if it's not hot. And I sweat peeling a banana. But if I have the cool down, it keeps the sweat, you know, the hat keeps sweat from coming down your face, but I don't like it because it makes me sweat more. And so the cool down really works. I like draping it around my neck more than I do on my head.
Yeah.
You know how to mess your hair up.
Yeah. Well, of course. This is expensive gel.
weren't you talking earlier about wasting money?
Hey,
he buys the gel
certain things he'll still do for beauty.
Yes, well, it's not working.
It's only on the live TV show days.
Ah, okay. Makeup,
a dress up for y'all.
Yeah, his hair's a disaster on other days.
Yeah, it's horrible. Looks all windblown.
I did forget something. Jason, you might find this interesting. Last Monday, we're in the process, and I think it's going to happen. I found down about an hour or so south of us in Bloomfield, Indiana, it's locally raised cows and pork, and they slaughter it, they process it. The stuff tastes amazing because there's not one freaking additive corn syrup thing. And the guy's name is Brian. He's bald and he's fat. And I got some of his brats this week, and I tried them all, and then I sold a few to all my customers that are always buying brats. I said, taste this, and the reaction was the same on every one of them. Unbelievable. Does pizza brats, all that stuff. But if we can make this work, we will no longer be selling Nathan's or any of that. We're going to go with our strictly raised locally and all that stuff. And it's amazingly good. So much.
Now you know why I do it.
You have your wife send me that dessert. Just throw in some of those brats. And that way you're not spending so much on dry ice.
We'll use the frozen brats to keep the cake cool.
Okay, that works.
I'm going to go stand out by the mailbox now.
Yeah. But I hope we can get this done because price-wise it comes in at a very doable deal to where, we're not going to freak people out on price. We'll still have our margin stuff. But just the taste of it alone, it floored me. The first brat I bit into, I scared the hell out of my wife because I just went, oh, my God.
Is there anybody doing breakfast brats?
I did this weekend. I just did the brats. What made it a breakfast brat was I put hash browns, pepper gravy, and maple syrup if you wanted it on it. It's really good.
There's a gentleman that is one of my customers that it does that. He went from working lunches to just now all he does is breakfast. And it's just breakfast brats, maple, bacon brats, all kinds of brats.
Right. We do that apple sausage for breakfast. It has a little bit of maple and a little bit of cinnamon in it.
Yep.
Wow.
I have AJ. Koopa, can you hear us?
I'm not even getting any feedback off his line, so there's nothing there. No audio feedback.
Jimmy's still here.
Do what? Oh, Jimmy, you still there with us?
Yeah, I'm still here.
I'm glad you are.
Listen, you guys.
Hey,
you know what? I got those tips. I mean, some more tips, call these companies for free stuff. I did the Hebrew National. They sent me 4 umbrellas, 20 T-shirts, 5 hats, all kinds of stickers, a banner, and all that for free.
Who was this?
So, Hebrew National.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I mean, I remember I went down to Daytona, and I told them I was going to sell their dogs down there.
Yep.
And the rep sent me all this stuff, questions. No questions asked. I'm talking about UPS in 3 days, had it on my doorstep. I'm talking about medium, large, extra large, and 2X T-shirts with Hebrew National, and the hats go with it. 4 umbrellas with Hebrew National all over it. A banner. I'm talking about a good, sturdy vinyl banner. All kinds of foil, the paper with Hebrew National to wrap your dogs in. Just in comparison, I called Nathan just to get a sign from them. They wanted me to sign a contract saying I would use them exclusively and give my Restaurant Depot number just to get a banner. So.
Oh, my gosh.
But there's free stuff you can do. Sabrats will send you a free umbrella. I mean, if you call Sabrats, and Vienna, of course you already know Vienna send you stuff.
Well, I teach in my book to use your local meat guys, like Bubba was talking about just a minute ago, is using local companies that people are endeared to already endears you to them automatically, vicariously. Just because if we have one called Lay's, and it's LAYS, and it's got three little pigs on the package. Well, everybody knows that it's in all the grocery stores here. And so if you put that on your cart, it does real well because they go, oh, yeah, I'm used to those hot dogs. They're the red hot dogs. It's the only red dogs we can get here.
We have Lay's potato chips here, and we also have hers. So the joke was always, are you hers or Frito-Lay?
Yeah, that's a good idea, Ben, because they didn't have a clue what Hebrew National was down in Daytona, Florida. Florida is used to Nathan and some Brett's.
Yeah.
So it was a hard sell, and I had no idea. You know, so it's good to check your local, you know, if you're going to do out-of-town events or events in your area, it's good to check to see what's the favorite dog in that area because they have no idea. Just like in Baltimore, half smokes are a staple there. And if you go outside of Baltimore, Maryland, D.C. area, nobody knows what a half smoke is.
Yeah.
I get that question all the time. What's a half smoke, you know?
What is a half smoke, Jimmy?
Know what it is. Go ahead and tell us what it is.
A half smoke is basically either a pork or beef sausage or both mixed together. That's kind of either hickory smoked or, like they say, half smoked and can be spicy or mild. Briggs is one of the companies that makes them. They got a local company called Mangler's Beef that makes them. And it's privy to the Baltimore area. I think you got a guy up in Baltimore. What was his name? Cowboy Joe? Cowboy Mike? You remember him? I think you had him on the show a while back. He was doing a radio station outside in Baltimore.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, he sells half smokes. He'll tell you what they are. But if you go outside this area, nobody knows what a half smoke is. And it's really, it can either be a hot dog or a sausage. So Brett's has a good one. It's called their hot sausage. They sell it in New York, and you can get it down here. And that's why I sell my half smoke. So it's a hot, spicy, used not cayenne, but red pepper in it, and it's a good smoked, half-smoked hickory beef. So all beef dog, no pork in this one. And so it's good to know what the local, what the people eat wherever you're vending that, because that really does work. Speaking of local, I did the water idea. I found Drink More Water, which is a local company, and they'll do the label advertisement for you for $15 a case, I think it is, of 24.
That's good.
And so, yeah, I mean, you know, and you can pass it on, like you say, to the person that wants to advertise on there. And I think they got a 3-case minimum, something like that. So
That's my free water trick. That's one of my tricks in the book is how to get free water.
Yeah, it works,
and it works. I was doing it with furniture stores, and it worked.
You know, I learned a lot from you. Check your local Sam's Club or Costco as a commissary. Since you do business there, some of them will let you use your restaurant certificate as a commissary for those that are having a hard time finding a base operation.
Yeah, I know some Sam's Clubs will let you. Some won't, but some will. I've heard both sides of the story. Hey, Jimmy, hang on. We've got another caller that's holding here, and I'm trying to get to them before we close up. Caller with the last four of 908 radio. Hello.
It's Andrew Supa. I can't get my camera and stuff working, but I'll be on by next week.
Hey, we thank you for sending in the tip. I guess you're Supa Dogs, right?
I am.
Okay. Well, we appreciate the tip. That was an awesome tip.
Oh yeah, not a problem. Like I said, I've been on here about 3 weeks now. So.
We were all rooting for you to win, but Kyle went a different way with it.
Set me up for failure.
Yes.
Welcome to the fold, brother.
Welcome to the whipping post.
I'll be on full blast next week.
Sounds good. Thank you so much. I see you keep jumping in and out, and hopefully we'll get it working. If you want to test it out any this week, if I'm available, if you'll email me, you and I can practice with it and see if it'll come on.
All right. Sounds good. I'm going to work tonight and maybe tomorrow afternoon to try to get the settings right for it.
Right.
I thought I could do it on my iPad, but I don't think the iPad, it doesn't work for some reason.
It should.
My wife does it with my daughters through it.
As long as it's the new iPad with the FaceTime camera.
It's kind of like smartphones. They're great, except I'm too stupid to know how to use them.
At least you're honest.
Well, I really appreciate all the calls this week. I appreciate everybody that joined us. And Jimmy, thanks for all the help and the update. That was fantastic. A lot of times we forget about this stuff, and I know we cover it, but this has been literally a jam-packed show full of tips and tricks and ideas. Do any of y'all have anything you want to add before you go?
No.
Let's see.
Going to be at it again for a week.
Well, Kyle will be doing the contest next week, so that's one less thing off the list for Bubba. I give him a little more time to build that card, deliver the ice cream. If, but, Jason, you know.
If Jason's not here next week, I had absolutely nothing to do with it.
Well, Ben and I were actually thinking about taking off, so it's going to be you and Brian running the show next week.
Yeah, running the Love Hot Dog Company.
Well, I'll jump in and help the guys out.
Right. Ben might be coming up this week and do some filming. We got some emails about a couple people wanted to see about water ice or shave ice, making those and flavors and things. So if Ben happens to come up here, we'll be doing a video on that for some people that have been asking about that. And that's about it for me.
I hope you give Brian a hard time because he didn't say kiss my ass or nothing. He just dodged out.
Wait till I get a hold of him. I'll text him next.
Tell him he threw a glitch in the show and we had to wait 30 minutes or something to get him locked
up. Well, it was probably that woman he had tied up that he disappeared earlier. She probably got out of her knots and stuff and he had to go tie her up again. She
broke the lock on the cage.
Well, folks, hey, Kyle, thanks for participating and being such a good sport. I hope you know it was all in good fun. We appreciate you joining us.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
Yes, sir.
Well, have a good one, Kyle.
What's that, Jason?
Have a good one, Kyle.
I will.
Hey, Bubba, get to building that cart now.
On it. On it like stink on crap.
Oh, man.
Hot Dog Vendor Radio was brought to you by BensCarts.com and the Hot
See y'all. Where is the button? See you, Ben.
See you later. I appreciate it.
Yeah, guys.
See you, Kyle.
Thank you for using Blog Talk Radio. Goodbye.